Everybody, Busy Dad, and today I'm going to show you a new project that I did for the workshop. I have a small space here in the basement that I get to do all my woodworking projects and other things, and I have to maximize all the space that I can as far as working in my workshop. So what I have here is a drill press table that I built using plans from Wood Magazine, March 2011, and I'll show you those plans and I'll show you a little bit about this workbench. So this is the magazine that I used to build the workbench. As you can see, it's from March 2011. And the project itself is a very easy project. You can see it's a nice small workbench that gives you a lot of storage. And if you've never used plans from a Wood Magazine issue, it's great because it gives you all the cut plans, but also it gives you all of the cut dimensions as well as the size boards that you need to get started. So it's very easy to build one of these projects. So here's the finished workbench, and there's a lot of storage that I said in this. The storage areas are a full 16 inches deep and gives you different size depths here for different parts of your workshop, different tools, different drill bits, router bits, but it gives you two large bins, three medium bins, and four small bins. That gives you a lot of versatility in what you use. Now you want to make sure that you use good casters so that it rolls smoothly and these lock up real nice when you're using it. And as far as the top is concerned, you want to make sure you have a nice smooth top so that you have a nice clean area to work on and it's easy to work clean up. Starting at the bottom of the cabinet, I chose really good casters that I found at Lowe's. These are about $7 to $9 depending on the size. But I picked a good caster because these are rated for just over 200 pounds a piece, plus of the locking mechanism, so that when these close up, you have a nice tight connection on the roller wheel itself. And these are going to last a lot longer than just buying inexpensive casters from a discount store. So here's a close-up shot of the drawers, or the bins that insert into this. They're all made out of 3/4 inch Baltic birch plywood. It's relatively inexpensive, but you want something that has a good finish on it so you have less finish work that you have to worry about. All of the edges are routed and round over with a 1/8 inch round over bit. You can get these in 1/4 and 1/2 inch collets, so all of my edges are nice and smooth, including the handholds on both sides. So these fully come out, and each side has a handhold so that you can carry these around the shop with you. Now, I'm sure there's a lot of you out there that are in the same situation that I am, where I have very limited amount of space in my workshop, so I have to maximize every piece that I have. So on top of the workbench here, I have mounted my 4-inch vise, the base of the drill press is through mounted using 1/4 inch bolts that through bolt the entire top of the cabinet. And then on the left hand side here, I have made a bit of a design change to the entire cabinet so that I have a 3/4 inch recess here. This is a double thickness workbench, so what this allows me to do is put multiple tools in here and hold them down with the clamps, and I can do my workspace here, take them out and put a different tool in. Alright, now let me show you this portion of the worktop. The way this works is that there are multiple tools that I have that are mounted on 3/4 inch pieces of plywood, and they simply slide into place, and then using the lever locks, it locks them into place and allows me to work on my piece. Now if you don't know what this is, it's a Craig jig, and it's a great tool for making pocket holes instead of using biscuits or other joinery techniques. It makes it real quick to use. You'll see this used throughout a lot of my videos. Once you're done with it, it's easy to simply release the levers and take the piece out. Now I also have a 6-inch bench grinder as well as a 24-inch belt sander and disc sander that mounts into this place as well. So once the workbench is built, to keep it lasting as long as you can and to keep it looking nice, what you want to do is finish it with a nice finish. What I chose to do is use boiled linseed oil. Now, if you're going to use that and still put a protective finish like a clear polyurethane, what you're going to want to do is make sure that you let the finish, let the linseed oil dry for at least a week before you put the finish on. It takes a while for linseed oil to dry out and to give you that finish that you're ready for before your polyurethane. So this has been the quick overview of this particular project. It makes for a handy work area. Even if you don't put a drill press like this on it, it still makes a nice, small, mobile workstation. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.